Hi everybody, I'm Julie. I'm a first year PhD student at RTE, the French Transmission System Operator. And this is Gilles, a master's student working for RTE and Artelys. And we are going to present you a Julia module for polynomial optimization with complex numbers. So first, Gilles is going to present you the module we have implemented for polynomial optimization problems with complex numbers. So the code is open source with a MIT license. So if you want to take a look, you can go to this address. But I warn you, it's still in development, so don't expect too much. Then I will present you another tool we have implemented, which is the Lasser hierarchy. And then I will present you an application to optimal power flow.
Okay, so first I'll present what we came up with for dealing with polynomial optimization problems with complex variables. So first, what is this thing? So basically, it's just an optimization problem which objective and constraints function are polynomials in complex variables and with complex coefficients. So basically, that's just it. And fixed upper and lower bounds on the constraints, which are also complex. One thing, though, is that usually the objective is real values, even though there are complex coefficients and complex variables. So how do we work with these polynomials and constraints? Well, we have defined several structures to deal with these optimization problems, and we define the algebraic operators in order to construct polynomials in an easy way. There are several types which are used to build up the polynomials. So we start from variables, and then from those we build exponents from which we can build polynomials, either with the constructors or with algebraic operators. And then we also have a point type that we can use to at which we can evaluate the polynomials. So let's look into more closely what these types are. So first, a variable is just a string and a type. And the types can be either complex, real, or Boolean, or integer. So we have several, and this defines the type of the variable. And so to define a variable, we have this syntax on the right column. So from these variables, we can define exponents. An exponent is just any product of variable, any product of variables, and so we can define it with this syntax, just with explicitly writing the times and the pow operators. Now, from these exponents, we can build polynomials, which are simply linear combinations of exponents with possibly complex coefficients. So this way, we could define this polynomial in such a way. And now that we have a polynomial, we can also evaluate them by using the point structure, which is simply associating a value to each variable. And then we can evaluate the polynomial at the given point. Now we have these structures for dealing with complex polynomials. We only lack a structure for the constraints and then the problem structure itself. So we define a constraint as simply a complex polynomial and two complex bounds, one upper and one lower bound. And that's it. The problem is finally a polynomial objective, several named constraints, and the set of variables that intervene in the problem. And so in the end, this is how we could define this optimization problem. We first define the two variables, then the objective polynomial, and the three constraints, polynomials, and then we start off with our empty problem, we set its objective, and we add the three constraints with this syntax that allows to, from which we can define construct objects and which is easy to read. Now, we have all the tools for constructing. Actually, we say in the end, it's just the real part is comprised between the real parts of the bounds and the complex, and the imaginary part of the polynomial is comprised between the imaginary parts of the bounds. So essentially, it's a rectangle in the complex plane in which we want to constrain our polynomial values. Okay. So now we have all the tools for constructing polynomial optimization problems. We can evaluate them at several points, and we have also a few functions to assess the quality of the given point with regards to the polynomial optimization problem. So the one thing that is left to do is solve these problems. And as there are not many solvers that directly deal with complex variables, we have to first convert them to real formulations. So there are two ways to do this: the rectangular form and the polar form. So we have implemented a method to convert a polynomial optimization problem in complex variable into a polynomial optimization problem in real variables, so with twice as many variables and up to twice as many constraints. And in the end, it's just calling this function complex to real. There is also the possibility to use the polar form, which introduces cosines and sines of the argument of each variable, each complex variable, that we have not done yet, mainly because it doesn't fit the polynomial optimization problem framework we wanted to work with. But this will be done at some point. And so now that what is left to do is to solve the real formulation. So we have two possibilities to do that. The first one is to convert this problem into a jump problem by calling this function, and then solve it. And so that's the log of Artemis Nitro for a problem with 18 variables and 27 constraints. So it takes about 0.2 seconds to solve, and on larger instances, it became even longer, obviously. And so we wanted to try another modeling language to see how that went. So we defined a formatted a text file that was able to describe explicitly any polynomial optimization problem along with a point that could be an initial point or a solution point. And from this export, we are able to work with other modeling languages or direct C++ code or anything we want, so we can work with other solvers. And so this is done with an ample working from our exported file, and still Artemis Nitro. And so basically it's just the same two line of commands. Then we fetch the Nitro solution point, and we call two utils function to get the minimal slack of our problem at our solution point and the objective value. And these are the two logs. So there is a difference in the execution time between jump and ample. I think it's related to the auto-differentiation. But we see the ratio is a little better when we get to higher instances with 5,000 variables and 8,000 nonlinear constraints. And we'll be happy to test it again with the new jump version and MathOpt interface.
So when your problem is not convex, you can only compute local solutions. So to evaluate the quality of your solutions, you need to compute lower bounds by solving convex relaxations. And so the Lasser hierarchy provides convex relaxations for polynomial optimization problem with complex variable. So more precisely, the Lasser hierarchy provides several SDP relaxations, which are tighter and tighter. So I think you all know what is an SDP problem, but just as a remind, this is a problem where you can find constraints on matrices. So the matrices has to be SDP, so semi-definite positive, which means they must have non-negative eigenvalues. And just as a remind, the dual of an SDP problem is also an SDP problem. And so the Lasser hierarchy provides a convergent sequence of SDP relaxations. So the Lasser relaxations are constructed from the moment matrices. And the moment matrices are constructed from the vector ZD, which are the vector of all the monomials you can build with an order less or equal to D. And then you can define the moment matrix at order D by the product ZD and the transpose conjugate of ZD. And so the higher the order, the bigger the moment matrix. So increasing the order improves the quality of the relaxation, but it increases significantly the size of the problems, which is a challenge for SDP. Sorry. So you can rewrite your original problem introducing the moment matrix of order D. Then you can replace the original variables Z by the coefficients of the moment matrix, which are the Y. And then the link between the variables are only in the last is only in the last constraint. And you can reformulate this last constraint by two equivalent conditions. So the moment matrix has to be SDP and its rank has to be 1. And to get an SDP relaxation, you just remove the rank constraint. So we have implemented the Lasserre hierarchy for polynomial problems in complex or real variables. So it's still in development, but we already have several options. So we can exploit spartiety. So we can split the set of exponents to have smaller cliques. So we can reduce the size of matrices in the SDP problem to have a better resolution. We can apply a multi-ordered hierarchy. So you can apply different orders on different constraints. So it's a way to improve the SDP relaxation while keeping an SDP problem which is not too big. And finally, if you have symmetries in your problem, you can specify them to simplify the problem. So for example, if you have this type of condition on your original problem, you can remove all the odd monomials. So most specifically, the workflow is as the following. So you have your polynomial optimization problem in complex variables. You can use our Lasserre hierarchy module to build an SDP relaxation. So either you use the primal relaxation, which is the moment relaxation, or the dual, which is the sum of square relaxation. At some point, you have to convert your problem into real numbers, and then you can solve it either using the package mosaic.gl or use an export to use another language. And the sparsity and multi-ordered options are related to chordal extension and clique decomposition. And there is a lot of work to do here to improve the resolution, so we are currently working on this part. Now I'm going to present you an application to optimal power flow in alternating current. So as I've mentioned, we are working for RTE, which is the French transmission system operator. And RTE needs tools for polynomial optimization in complex number because the alternating current modeling involves complex quantities. So the voltage, the current, the power flow. And having such a tool will permit to reduce the time spent in testing method. So now I'm going to explain you briefly what is an optimal power flow problem. So first, the power transmission networks can be modelized as oriented graphs where the nodes represent electrical demand or generation points, and the arcs represent transmission lines. And the objective is to find an optimal dispatch which meets the demand, minimizes the cost, and satisfies physical laws and engineering constraints. So from the mathematical point of view, there are several variants of optimal power flow, but basically there are two types of complex variables. You have one voltage at its bus and one power at its generation bus. And then you have a power flow equations at each node, so power in equals power out. And what is important to note here is that the powers on the line are quadratic functions of the voltages, but they only involve Hermitian products. Then there are safety constraints, including thermal limits on branches, in which we find polynomials of degree 4 in voltages. And finally, the objective is to minimize the real generation costs. So the optimal power flow is typically a polynomial optimization problem with complex variables. So, excuse me, we can tackle this problem with our modules. So we can build an optimal power flow from different entry formats. So it's really modular, so we can adapt to a different entry format, and we can consider the elements of the networks we want. We can add the variables, the constraints, the cost we want. So it's really modular as regards the entry format, but also the formulation of the optimal power flow problem. Once we have a polynomial optimization problem with complex numbers, we can convert it into real numbers using rectangular form in order to solve it. Then we can compute feasible solution with ample and nitro, and compute lower bounds using Lasser hierarchy and MOSAIC. So we have tested this method on the grid optimization competition instances. So this is a big challenge launched by ARPA-E, the Advanced Research Project Agency Energy. So the problem to solve is an optimal power flow problem in which contingencies are anticipated. So for example, we expect the loss of a line, and the idea is to find a solution which is feasible in the best case, but also when this line is lost. The problem can be formulated as a mixed integer polynomial problem with complex numbers. And we are in the phase zero of the competition, so we have several data sets which 100 scenarios for each one, but the networks are quite small, so we have 1473 buses. But due to contingency, the problem can be quite big. So with our modules, we succeed to solve a lot of instances, but not all of them at the same time. Actually, if we adapt the scaling to the instance, we can find feasible solution for all of them, but we don't succeed to solve all of them at the same time with the same scaling. So we are still working on it to find a perfect scaling. And for the two datasets with 14 buses, the problem are solved to global optimality because we have computed lower bounds which prove that our feasible solutions are globally optimal. But for this network, for now the problem is bigger and is too big, and we have to implement chordal extension and click decompositions which are more efficient to be able to compute our bounds. So for future works, we are going to collaborate with Carlton Coffrin to integrate our works in its module powermodels.gl. We are going to implement the conversion using polar form. We are going to work again on the resolution using jump with the new versions. And we are going to implement other conic relaxations such as ISOCP. So to conclude, we have presented a tool for polynomial optimization problems with complex variables. So we can solve locally the problems, but also we can compute lower bounds using Lasser hierarchy. And the application to optimal power flow problems demonstrates the convenience of such a toolbox. And it may be convenient for other problems which are originally formulated in complex numbers. But this is still in development, so we are thinking about creating Julia packages, so one for the polynomial optimization with complex numbers, including Lasser hierarchy module, and one for the optimal power flow problems. And maybe we can contribute into existing Julia packages, such as PolyJump or SummerSquares. And in any case, we are looking for Julia developers to support RTE research around this tool. So thank you for your attention, and if you have questions.